Hello and welcome to my video, lesson 6.2 on parallel and perpendicular lines. So here are two parallel lines. What do you notice about the slopes? So basically, first of all, we need to find the slope of each of these lines. So let's find the purple line first. Normally I do rise first. So we go down by 1, right? And we go over to the right by 3 before we hit the next corner, go down by 1, over by 3. Normally I'll do it twice just to kind of prove to myself that I got it correct. So negative 1 over 3. Okay, that's good. Let's see if what the red line slope is. Negative 1 over to the right by 3. Hey, look at this. Let's try it again. 1, 1, 2, 3. Looking good. So the slope here is also negative 1 over 3. So for parallel lines, the slopes are the same. Actually, we'll be writing that down in a second down here, so I don't need to write it right now. Because we'll be writing it down here. Here are two perpendicular lines. What do you notice about the slope? Excuse me. What do you notice about the slope? Okay, so we need to find the slope for each of these. So here we go down, Here we go down by 1 and over to the right by 2. Down by 1, over to the right by 2. So the slope is negative 1 over 2. Whoops, I want to keep that part. All right, fantastic. Let's take a look at the purple line. So this one goes up by 2, over to the right by 1. Up by 2, over to the right by 1. Okay, what do we notice about this slope? It's 2 over 1. So if we look at these two slopes and we compare them, what do we notice? Well, hopefully you notice that they are negative reciprocals. So if you take the first slope, okay, and if you take the first slope and you flip it first, then you multiply by a negative 1, and then times by, it gives you the second slope. So the term for this is a negative reciprocal. Negative means times by 1, and reciprocal means flip. So in general, parallel lines have the same slope. Perpendicular lines have negative reciprocal slopes, which just basically means what we wrote up here. All right, so just in general for this topic, you can see a set of parallel lines up here. You can see a set of perpendicular lines. What does perpendicular mean, just in case you don't know? It means there's a 90 degree angle here. Okay, parallel means that they're never gonna touch, no matter how far into the, you know, you go into the future. Okay, so, let's zoom in again. Which of the following lines are parallel? So we're going to look at all these lines and try to figure out which ones are parallel. So basically we need to find the slope for all of these lines. Now you might be able to just look at it and be able to tell, but it may or may not be very easy to tell. So let's just check each of these slopes. 1, 2, 3, 4. and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is 4/5, sorry, -4/5, because we went down by 4. Okay, the red one is 1 up, 2 to the right, 1 up, 2 to the right, so it is 1/2. Okay, the blue one is 1 up, 2 to the right, 1 up, 2 to the right, so it is also 1/2. So now we just need to check one more. I'm making it yellow, so it's gonna match. So this one's down by 2, over to the right by 1. Oh no, not even. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2. So it's -5/2, and that actually cannot be simplified. So you can see here that the blue and red lines are parallel. All right. Determine the slope of a line that is perpendicular to the following. And now we're given some equations. So we need to make perpendicular lines to these equations' slopes. So for the first one, we can see that the slope is 3/1, or 3, right? Actually, let's just go start with 3, which is the same thing as writing 3/1. Now we're going to flip it. Okay, then you're going to multiply by a -1. So it's going to be -1/3. So the slope of a line perpendicular to the first thing is going to have a slope of -1/3. Okay, this next one is -2/3 to start. Okay, I highly recommend that you try this out yourself and see if you can find the right answer before I write it up here. I'm going to actually just press that button because it makes it a little bit more pretty. So anyways, this slope starts off as -2/3. Your first step is to flip it, which is 3/-2, then to times by -1, which makes it 3/2. So the slope of a line that's perpendicular to that is going to have a slope of 3/2. Okay, and I believe this is the last question, yep, for this video. I'm just trying to make it so I can see the whole thing in one go. There you go. Find a point on the line CD that is parallel to AB. Okay, so first of all, what we have to do is we have to find the slope of line AB. So this has a slope of 1, 2, 3, -1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. So this has a slope of -3/2. That's the slope of the line. So if it's parallel to AB, it's going to have the same slope. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. That's going to be a point. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. That's going to be a point. So find a point on a line that is parallel. Well, CD, D could be either one of these points, at least on this graph here that I've done. Okay, so you could have answered 6, 4 or 8, 1, and both of those answers would be correct. Either one would be correct. All right, so I hope this video helps you better understand parallel and perpendicular lines. Basically, parallel lines have the same slope as each other. Perpendicular lines have a negative reciprocal slope. I hope this video helped, and good luck.